Oh, man. Look at that. Oh, dude, it's Jupiter. Oh, snap.
It's Pluto. Oh, is that the moon?
No way. Yeah, no, we're not talking about that cosmos. We're talking about the blockchain cosmos. You know, the internet of blockchains. What is Cosmos? What is the Atom token? What problems is it looking to solve? Like, what is it looking to do? Is it just like a regular blockchain? Well, in today's KuCoin DigiDive, we're going to dig into Cosmos and the Atom token. If you guys are ready to go and get started trading with this token, there's a link in the description below. It'll give you 20% off trading fees, baby. All right, so before we get into this, let's just go ahead and go into the website and see what it looks like. Well, as you guys can see here, this is what they are touting the Cosmos as. The internet of blockchain. Cosmos, an ever-expanding ecosystem, whatever. All right, so the TLDR on what the Cosmos is that it's multiple blockchains being glued together through IBC. So IBC stands for Inter-Blockchain Communication. Basically, what Cosmos is seeking to do is allow all these other dApps and projects to be able to communicate with each other. Currently, as we sit today, you either are on Ethereum, you're on Binance Smart Chain, you're on Polygon, you're on Phantom, you're on Avalanche, just whatever chain. And you have to use bridges in order to get between these different projects. Now, this is a security concern, and it's also a speed concern. The reason why it's a security concern is you are now having to depend on third-party intermediaries, like the bridges, for security. And how many times have these been hacked? Oh yeah, like a lot. And in total, there's been billions of dollars that's been lost through these bridge hacks. Some of the largest ones, to name a few, are Poly Network and Wormhole. These were almost $1 billion a piece, which is a ton of money. And this shouldn't be happening. It just shouldn't, because we shouldn't have to depend on bridges in order to do this. So Cosmos is getting rid of that issue, and they do this by making all of these projects create their own templates. They must meet the standards of Tendermint. Tendermint is the name of the template that they have to follow. This is basically every dApp and every project that builds on Cosmos has to build using Tendermint. So that way, each and every protocol can communicate with each other because they're built on the same thing. They're all built on Tendermint. Now that you understand that part, now what happens with network security? If everyone's having to build their own chain and build their own dApp and have their own validators and run their own network security, how do they run their own nodes? Well, this is where the project has to take on that responsibility. Now, Polkadot takes a different standard to where you can rent network security through their parachains, but Cosmos allows any project to run their own chain, have their own chain, and if their chain goes down, it's not going to affect the others. Whereas on Ethereum or Phantom or Polygon, if there is a new farm that launches and it just juices a bunch of gas fees, well, the whole entire chain is useless because nobody can get a transaction through because the gas fees are astronomical. Just like when the Bored Ape Yacht Club had the land mint. Ethereum was unusable. You had to pay thousands upon thousands of dollars in order to send a simple transaction. Now, if I'm sending someone 10 bucks, what the snap? It's not even worth it. Let's say, for example, Ethereum was its own chain built on Cosmos. Well, Ethereum would be all congested over there, and all the other chains on Cosmos would be able to do their own thing. Now, it's not as simple as that for developers because they do have to run their own validators and nodes, so there is a little more complexity than spinning up your own dApp, but with more responsibility, you get more privileges. The privilege is you have your own chain, you don't have to depend on others, and you can do your own thing. And better yet, you do not have to depend on bridges. So let's go and dig into this website a little more, just show you guys some graphics to see some of the pros and cons of Cosmos. As you guys can see here, they have $86 billion plus in assets under management. These are the ones that are just built on Cosmos. There are several projects actually built on Cosmos. Just to name a few are Akash, you got Juno, you got Osmosis, you got SifChain, you got Terra Luna, you got ThorChain. There's tons of them. Even Binance Chain, not Binance Smart Chain, but the BEP2 chain, which is Binance Chain. This is actually built on Cosmos as well. There are a ton of projects using Tendermint. You can also go on CoinGecko to see all of them there. As you guys can see here, this is the goal and vision of Cosmos. Cosmos and the Atom token, they are their own hub. each and every protocol has their own hub. Like Juno is its own hub. Osmosis is its own hub. Now, whatever happens on Osmosis has no effect on Juno. And whatever happens on Juno has no effect on Osmosis. These are completely separate, but then you have the Cosmos hub that brings all of these guys together. It's the glue. It allows interoperability for these chains to communicate. So if I have some USDC on Juno, I can bridge through Cosmos and bring my USDC on Osmosis. I'll show you guys that later in the video so you guys can see this. But serving as the economic center of the Cosmos is the Cosmos hub. And this is secured and validated by the Atom token. So here are a couple of use cases for Atom and the Cosmos hub. It wants to be a marketplace, a security provider, a router, and a custodian. You can also stake this token. Currently, it earns about 16 to 17% per year. Here's a couple of perks on the Cosmos hub. Transactions and all the transactions for any Tendermint-based chain is 7-second transaction speeds and less than a penny for the transactions. It's actually super cheap, and some chains even have gas-free transactions. They also have 99% lower carbon footprint because they're a proof-of-stake chain. A couple of projects you can build on Cosmos are DeFi, you can build DAOs, you can build GameFi, you can do NFTs, you can do a little bit of everything. And you can even get a grant with Cosmos. Atom is considered the funding token for some of these early projects. And a lot of these projects actually pay homage to Atom. If you're staking your Atom, this is an alpha leak, you can actually earn some free airdrops. Literally, the projects that launch on Cosmos, they tend to, when they launch their token, airdrop people staking their Cosmos token. If you've already heard of Polkadot, you're probably like, well, what the snap? There is no difference between Polkadot and Cosmos. Actually, there is. And the best way to do this is with an example. So how you can compare Polkadot and Cosmos is like the mall and a town. What you can consider Polkadot is the mall. Inside the mall is all these shops, different centers, all these different parachains that are built on Polkadot. Now, when the mall closes down, all of those shops have to close down. So it's depending on the Polkadot network to be functional. So if there's ever congestion or it shuts down, all the different stores close down inside that protocol. However, each and every shop and store has their own rules in the mall. So like you can go to a haircut store, or you can go to a bar that's inside the mall, and a certain people or a certain person can go there. Like for example, a bar, you have to be 21 years or older. But then again, you can have a toy store right next door to it that has its own rules, like anyone is welcome. Or one store can close at 8 o'clock and the other closes at 10. They all have their own rules. However, they do have to abide by the rules of the mall. Now you have something like Cosmos. Cosmos, you can kind of consider it like a shop that's on the side of the road. There's tons of shops on the sides of the road, but the road never closes. Anyone and everyone can pull up to any shop that they want at any time they want, but the shop has its own rules. That shop can say, hey, I want to close at 10 p.m. and another one can say 8 p.m. But that road is always functioning. So at any time, that store can create its own rules, but it's never bound to the rules of the Cosmos hub in general. So if Cosmos hub closed down, the other shops and stores are still doing their thing. Whereas in the mall example for Polkadot, if the mall closes down, well, all the other shops have to close down in there. That's how you guys can understand the difference between Polkadot and Cosmos. Now let's go ahead and show you guys a couple of dApps built on Tendermint. Here's the first one. This is Osmosis. You guys can kind of see this is the actual layout. This is the asset page. You can see I can deposit any assets I want from any chain that's built on Cosmos. Now there are some chains that are not built on Cosmos that are actually interoperable through bridges. For example, like ETH and USDC, this is using the Axelar bridge in order to do this. But Crypto.com and CRO, they have their own chain. You can simply just say, hey, I want to deposit. This is an IBC transfer. And IBC transfers typically take about 5 to 7 minutes. Whereas other bridge transactions, they actually take 15 to 30 minutes minimum. Sometimes they take even longer. Then you have something like Secret Network, Juno. These are all their own chain. They have their own validators, their own validator network, their own nodes. They have their own proof of stake network that's being validated and secured by their own token. And I can deposit them through Osmosis. Now, let's say, for example, I'm done with Osmosis. Let's say, for example, I have some Atom token right here, and I want to bring this on Osmosis. Well, I simply just deposit. This will bring from my Atom balance straight to Osmosis, and now I have Atom here that I can trade and swap between other tokens. Now, say I'm done. I'm done with Osmosis. I want to bring my Atom over to Juno. I can either go to Juno Swap or I can go to Emeris. Emeris is also known as the Gravity DEX. And you can actually send and receive to any of these different projects. Let's say, for example, I want to move assets between different addresses on different chains. Well, I have some Atom token. So I can take the Atom that I have on Cosmos Hub and I can say, I want to bring Atom to Akash Network. Yeah, let's do this. You can do that. You can literally change these tokens or swap these tokens into any of these chains that you want. And the transactions happen in seconds. Like literally, they're confirmed. And then obviously the IBC transfer, sometimes it takes about 5 minutes and sometimes it's actually about 1 minute. It's super quick. So now that you guys understand the vision of Cosmos, what they're looking to do, and a couple of projects that are built on Cosmos, what the snap is this Atom token used for? Currently, Atom is used for governance and securing the Cosmos Hub. There is not much built on the Cosmos Hub currently. In the future, we should have more being built on it. But currently, at its stages, the Atom token is not securing any of these other chains. It's just securing the Cosmos Hub. However, in the future, securing the IBC network is going to be super important, and the Cosmos token is going to be, in my opinion, the one that inherits this opportunity. So I see Atom as providing that security for the IBC transfer. So what are my thoughts in general? Well, I really like the optionality and the abilities that Tendermint provides for these different projects. I like how it allows the projects to have their own network security, allow their own transactions and what they do on that chain to not affect other chains. However, for the Atom token, there is not a great value capture mechanism. However, if they do flip a switch that says, hey, any of the transactions that process through IBC between these different chains, any of the people that are staking the Atom tokens will get a portion of their fees, I think it could be really gangbusters for the Atom token in general. And even implementing something like in any of the transactions that are on the chain, go to burn the Atom token because it is inflationary. I think these will be very beneficial to the Atom token in general. But until those are in place, right now I see Atom as a airdropping coin and one that currently has staking yield. Now where those yields come from is for another video. But in general, I like the Tendermint technology, and I think it will have a vibrant future. I hit you guys with a wisdom one-liner. Proverbs chapter 15, verses 22. Plans fail for lack of counsel, but with many advisors, they succeed. You know what they say, two heads are always better than one. Thanks for tuning in to this KuCoin DigiDive. And if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you guys like, subscribe, and hit that bell notification on this channel. You guys can see some previous videos here, 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 and like, there. And there's also a link in the description below so you guys can get 20% off trading fees, baby. I'll see you in the next one.